1971, the African Development Bank began its partnership with Zambia, and since then has provided over $2 billion to Zambia with a focus on public sector infrastructure projects.
The African Development Bank is one of the key institutions on the continent for financing development, for resource mobilization. So it's very critical to Zambia, as it is critical to the other member countries on the African continent.
At the end of 2015 alone, the bank's portfolio consisted of 18 ongoing and approved operations at a value of $886 million. These operations are aligned with the bank's 2013 to 2022 strategy, with the twin objectives of inclusive growth and transition to green growth.
Zambia has been growing rather fast over the last 10, 15 years, making it a lower middle-income country.
The operations are also in line with the priority areas of the bank. The high fives, which are Light Up and Power Africa, Feed Africa, Industrialize Africa, Integrate Africa, and Improve the Quality of Life for the People of Africa. The support from the bank cannot be explained by numbers alone, but seen through the impact it has had on the people of Zambia. One such example is the small-scale irrigation projects in Neganega, in Nzenga, and Sinazongwe, where irrigation infrastructure and civil works have been completed.
This area, before the irrigation system came in, they were just growing some maize, few groundnuts, a bit of cotton. Otherwise, the income was very little. People couldn't even bear live, and they used to have those droughts.
At the end of the year, we were not getting anything because of water.
This water comes from the Kafue River, then it's pumped up here. We have three dams. From here again, the water more flows back with canals. That's where now we have our fields, and we are tapping our water.
This is part of the bank's priority area of Feeding Africa, ensuring that sustainable infrastructure supports the development of agricultural value chains as well as rural enterprise.
This year, I think we are going to get something because we are going to sell it to Nagambala Sugar. Our life here has been changed. Even our children, they are going to have more chance to go to school.
To date, the project has developed 1,413 hectares of irrigated land, benefiting 977 households. Energy is a key investment for the bank, as powering Africa is a priority for both human development and economic prosperity. The bank and its partners have invested in the Kariba Dam Rehabilitation Project.
The African Development Bank is co-financing the project with three other financiers.
The dam might be compromised at the base. We could have a catastrophe.
In the event of dam failure, it will affect more than 3.5 million people.
The problem will be exacerbated to the extent that power stations will cease to operate. We are determined to give a new, fresh breath of life to Kariba Dam.
It will assure us a constant supply of over 1,300 megawatts worth of power.
The bank supported the Eteshi Teshi Power Project for the construction and operation of a 120 megawatt hydropower station and transmission line.
Zambia has been facing a power deficit in the past several years. This is one of the projects which is being implemented to try to meet that power deficit.
The electricity is a problem for now. You are making a small money.
Availability of energy means you can have more industry, more employment, and you can increase employment in the country.
At least if they can make us to have more power, I can work hard as welder, be easy to support my family.
And therefore it will just bring up the full productivity of the country.
Focusing on regional integration, the bank has supported transport infrastructure such as the Kazungula Bridge project linking Zambia and Botswana, a project that was approved in 2011 at a cost of $80 million.
The road between Zambia and Botswana, the big hassle is a ferry, because when I was coming, I spent about 7 days on queue waiting to cross from Botswana side to Zambian side. We are hoping if the bridge is finished, then I think things can be okay now. Maybe we might be spending maybe a day, then you cross to be better.
Our strategy in the country is to develop these corridors to open up Zambia, to link up with its neighbors, to boost trade and regional integration.
AFDB will continue to work with communities, private sector, other donors, and the government of Zambia to support ways to improve the lives of the Zambian citizens.